We are back. Welcome everybody to Adirondack Art Company lesson. We are going to do one of my favorite drawings, which is kind of a underwater scene, which I'm super excited about. Got some people popping on today, so that's sweet. We'll go turn a couple more lights on here, and we are gonna get going. I'm super excited to see some people that were posting some of the drawings that they did. That's really cool. It's really neat to see that kind of everybody around is kind of doing the same thing, and we're all kind of just rocking some drawings out. I love that. Love it. Gonna be flying solo today, but that's okay. Even the dogs are inside sleeping. So yesterday we knocked out some animals. I had a lot of people send me their animals. Here's some of the ones that we did. We'll probably practice our shark again and our jellyfish again, just because we're going to do this underwater scene, which I think is super cool. So as always, let's start with a blank sheet of paper. A lot of people like coloring pages. I like my blank pieces of paper much better. So here we go. All right. All right. Right about there. Cool. Got more people bouncing on. One thirty-one right now, so everybody should be good to go. All right, got some more peeps signing on. Cool. So first thing I'm gonna do, actually, since I have to kind of to make sure everybody is good at seeing this, I'm gonna tape my picture down in case I bump it. I can keep it good to go. Here we go. Excellent. All right, so if you were here for the outside picture that we did, which I love, that is one of my favorite pictures, we're going to start down here, actually. And the first thing I want you guys to do is we're going to draw kind of the bottom of the ocean. So it's kind of sandy. At least that's the way we're going to make it look. So we're going to draw just a line on the bottom, kind of wavy, just like that. All right. It's not straight. Nice and sandy bottom. So let's start over here. Grab another piece of tape here. Tape this guy down. Let's start maybe about four fingers up and make a line that comes down like this. And this is going to be our cave. All So just a little line coming down, not even halfway up, more like maybe a third of the way up. And then from the bottom, we're going to make the cave opening kind of big. Just like that. And then in the middle of it, we're going to make a set of eyes. And here's again how I do my eyes. And you can do your eyes however you want. And that's all I'm going to do. I'm just going to put a set of eyes in the cave. And we don't really know what it is, but we know that something lives in there. And when I'm ready to color this, I'm gonna color this all black, and then all you're gonna see are the eyes popping out. So I got some more people still signing on. That's awesome. We really didn't get that far. All we did is we did the sandy bottom of the ocean, and then we just did a little line up here, and then a line in the middle for the cave. And some eyeballs, that's all we did. So I'm sure that you guys can catch up with that. You guys can hear it's pretty windy out there, actually. My garage doors are rocking right now. That's okay, get some of the pollen out of the air. So, one more time, you just did the bottom. We did our cave. Our cave opening, and then some eyes, and that's as far as we got. All right, so we're gonna do a little bit of decorating on our cave here. And very easily, we're just gonna kind of give it just a little bit of texture. So just make a couple lines here, just to give it a little texture. And I'm gonna draw a starfish. So there is a starfish on my cave. And then on top of the cave, go ahead and put some seaweed. And seaweed is very simple. You can make seaweed in a couple different ways. You can make it thick, where you could kind of put two lines together, or we can just make it kind of wavy. This is kind of like the seaweed up at my house where I used to live in northern New York. It was just kind of like really, really fine seaweed. And we'll go ahead and we'll put that into a couple different spots. And someone just asked me, can you put a second pair of eyes in the cave? That's a great idea. Never thought of that. That's a good idea. And right over here on this side right here, I'm going to do kind of like a piece of coral because we always have coral growing off of our rock. And how I do my coral is I'm just kind of making lines come out. Maybe make it a little bit thicker at the bottom. Now, obviously, this is going to look a lot better with color. Because when we're talking about under the ocean, we're talking about a lot of color. And then just kind of a quick cartoon trick. I'm going to put a couple dots on certain spots of the rock. And the reason why we do that is because it kind of gives it a little bit of texture. And it makes it a little bit more interesting when we look at it. And again, we're going to color this dark when we start using our colors. Pretty cool. All right, let's get some fish in here. Let's get some animals in here. That's kind of what really makes underwater scene so underwatery. And then we'll go back and I'll make some more stuff. All right. Okay, so let's start right over here. And let's see here. How about we do. Let's just do a jellyfish since we did a jellyfish before. Remember yesterday we did a nice goofy jellyfish, and that's how we're gonna do our jellyfish today. So here are my eyes. And again, we just put kind of two circles together, no big deal. And then from the left side of the eye, we come down, we make a little bit of wave. Just like that. And then we put different types of tentacles coming down from him. I do swirls. Curly Q's and then just straight lines just to make him look interesting. Now, if you like the jellyfish action, which I honestly don't know how you don't, because he's pretty baller. Obviously, you can put multiple jellyfish on here. Pretty cool. All right. So, right above the jellyfish, this is kind of an idea that just popped into my head one day, and I don't remember why I did this. Maybe I saw it on a cartoon or something like that. And then I've done it ever since. So here is a really cool way to make it look like there are like maybe teeny, teeny, tiny fish up here, or we could give it the effect that there are minnows or a school of fish. So here's what we're going to do, and I'm going to zoom right in on this so you guys can check this out because I really think this is neat. So we're going to make ovals. Just like this. And I don't want all the ovals to be the same because that's kind of boring. So check out all these little ovals here. Now, I know they look kind of boring, but we're going to make it look as though they are so far in the distance that these fish aren't really going to have a whole lot of detail anyway. Because all we're really seeing is kind of their silhouette. We don't see their gills, we don't see their eyes, we don't see any of that. All right, so on the very back of the fish, we're going to put kind of like a backwards letter C. Oh, what? Yep, I know. I know. There they are. There they are. I don't care who you are, that's pretty cool. That is pretty cool. And kind of just like the jellyfish, you can do this really anywhere on your paper if you needed to. You could put them absolutely everywhere. And that is a good way to kind of fill the empty space, or what I call negative space. Just real quickly, like all of this right here, this is all negative space because there's nothing here, at least not yet. All right, so we already started drawing some of our fish, and I think we're on the right path here. I want to go ahead and do something else. Now, we could take the whole paper and fill it with animals because honestly, the ocean is not lacking of wildlife. But I actually want to do a couple other things, and we could do a shipwreck because a shipwreck is pretty easy. But I want to do something a little bit different. And maybe we'll add a shipwreck in a minute. So right down here, kind of centered right in the middle of your paper, I want you guys to do this. I want you guys to start at the bottom and do nice wavy lines and make kind of a hill. And make sure it has a flat top. All right. So this is what I want you guys to do. And I know some of you guys may say, whoa, it looks like a volcano. Yeah, it does, but that's not what we're drawing. It does look like a volcano, but that's not what we're doing. So we're going to draw this, and then if enough people want to do a shipwreck, we could do a shipwreck too. We might even draw for a little bit longer today because I really, really love doing this drawing. I've done it a bunch. So here's what we're gonna do. Now, since my real job is being a social studies teacher and I'm a history geek and I'm really, really into ancient cultures and stuff like that, we're gonna draw kind of like an ancient Greek or ancient Roman temple. And here's how we're gonna do it. Let's go ahead and make two little lines here and here on both sides of your hill. Then, as straight as you can, we're going to link those two just like that. So now we have the foundation of our little building. Now go ahead and maybe about a finger's width, and if you got little fingers, maybe two. Right on top of that, I'm going to draw another one. Another rectangle that's the same size. So fresh. So fresh. Now, you could get your ruler out if you want to, but we're just kind of having fun right now, so I'm not really too stressed about it. I'll go back and get my fancy pants pencil. Now, I'm going to take a dot right above the middle, right there. See my dot? Trying to wave to everybody that signs on here. I don't know if I'm doing a good job of it or not, but I'm trying. I appreciate all my friends coming to check me out. Hopefully, their kids are having as much fun as I am. So after we have that dot there, and the only reason why I do that dot is to just make sure that my triangle is kind of centered. And even if it's not centered, that's okay. We're doing an Acropolis. The Acropolis in Athens, Greece. Acropolis means high city. And we're trying to do kind of like a Parthenon on top. Pretty neat. So here comes the cool part. On the outsides, we're going to draw columns, and the columns can be very, very simple. They can just be little lines going down. And what I do is I usually put mine in batches of three or four. So here we go. One, two, three, Four.
Oh.
One, two, three, four. And then I skip a space. Boom. Boom. And there's my Acropolis. Now, usually the Acropolis, or excuse me, the building, I'm gonna make just kind of a little triangle inside the triangle. That's gonna kind of give it a little bit of depth. And then it usually kind of has some type of what's called a frieze or a picture in here, but it's too far away for us to really make out. Now, obviously, this is underwater too, and we want to show that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make some seaweed on top of the building. So fresh. That looks freshy fresh. Now, obviously, people had to walk up to get to this building. Maybe it was like a holy site or something like that. Meeting place of some sort. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw kind of like the stairs, but the stairs are going to be kind of wavy because they're not nice stairs anymore. They've been covered in gunk. And the trick is to make your stairs really, really tiny up close. And then as you get closer to the bottom, they get bigger because those stairs are a little bit closer to us, and they're more realistic in size. And plus, it looks really neat. Pretty cool. All right, last one down here. And if you don't want to do these stairs, that's okay. Now, just to make it look like this is kind of like like definitely old, like very old, we're gonna just put some random columns. Maybe we'll just put like a column sticking out of the side of the hill. But for this column, I'm gonna put like a top on it. But maybe there was a statue sitting there. Some seaweed coming out. Maybe I'll make a broken column. Oh, what? So here's a column that busted off. So here's a column kind of at the side leaning over. Maybe I'll make a larger column down here just because this one's way in front. Then we'll put some barnacles on it. Just a little, some dots here. Show the barnacles and more seaweed. All right, so now we have a pretty good background. Now this looks even cooler. And I had somebody who would really, really like to see a crab. And I would love to honor that request and do a crab because crabs are easy. Let's go ahead and put our crab right down here. Let's do it here in case I want to put something else in that corner. All right, so we'll put a crab right down here. Get some more light up in here. All right, so here's a crab. So kind of a straight line with a little bump on the top. And then we're going to mirror this and do a straight with that straight line and do one on the bottom. It kind of looks like a pie. And then for the legs, pretty sure they have six. So line down, and then here's the fun part of Mr. Crab. Here's his eyes. What do you guys think of that? Is that pretty crabby? Maybe you could put some little pinchers on the front. Or we could turn them into kind of a lobster thingy. That's super easy. So make a couple other arms, maybe coming right out of the top of him. And very easy, do like a C. And then make the jagged pinchers there. I am loving the crab. So crabby. So crabby. There, not too bad of a crab. I'm digging it. All right, so let's get to some other bigger fish because I know you guys are probably really wanting to do some fish. So if you were here yesterday, that's awesome. We're going to kind of draw a shark. I love sharks because honestly, they're kind of a little bit scary to me. And when I draw them like this, they're no longer scary. So here we go. I'm gonna draw my googly eyes as usual. I'm gonna draw a big long nose, just like that. So, give you guys a second. Everybody catch up. Yeah, we'll do a shipwreck. We can do a shipwreck and an octopus. Absolutely. So here's your shark. Now, I told you guys yesterday that the difference between a shark and a dolphin, the body is pretty similar. When I draw a dolphin, I make the tip of the fin a lot rounder, so it's not sharp, but a shark has a sharp fin. And then we come up, do kind of a half moon for the tail. So we're just coming from the back, making a wedge, coming up, and then kind of draw like a half moon, a big half moon for his back. And then I go back to his mouth, and we come up here, and then we stop right here because we want to put his fin. Put a remora on the shark. That's a good idea. We can do that. And then, of course, we have to put his other fin in the background. We're just going to put a little bump right here because his fin in the background is hidden by his body. And it's just a little bit shorter than his other one. Someone also wants to put a sombrero on the shark. It's your drawing. You want a sombrero? Rock a sombrero. And of course, we want to make sure that we're putting some big, silly looking sharp teeth on our shark. Now, if we want to make our shark mad, we're going to practice with our eyebrows and our eyelids. Right now, he's surprised looking. He's surprised. If we're going to make him angry, watch this. Down, 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 down. Now he's angry. Super easy cartoon trick. I don't think sharks are angry as they are hungry. I think they're just hungry a lot. Pretty cool. All right, what were some of those other things that people were asking me to do? Oh, yeah. A shipwreck. Let's go ahead and knock out the shipwreck. So a lot of times when I'm doing this cartoon, instead of this kind of Acropolis Greek situation here, I would just do like a shipwreck here. But since we kind of focused on this, we're going to add just a smaller shipwreck right here. Okay, so let's go ahead into the bottom right-hand part. And here is a shipwreck. So we're going to start just kind of with a nice line, and this is going to be the bow of the ship. Okay. Now, I know it doesn't look like much, but stay with me, it will. We can have a lot of different directions going on this one. Ooh, someone has to do a mermaid. That's a good idea, too. Man, we're going to have a busy paper here. That's awesome. So, coming up from the middle, I'm going to go ahead and put what's called one of the masts of the ship. And the masts is just kind of like a great big pole. And I want you guys to draw it very close to what I have. And we're basically already on our way of drawing a ship. And we only really drew about, I don't know, six lines. Now, here's how we can really make it look like a good ship. We want to draw, we don't have to draw each one, but we want to draw the boards that make up the ship. And I'm only going to draw a couple of them. Now, we're not exactly sure how this boat got here, but we know that something happened to it. So what I like to do is I like to make it look like it broke in half. And I just put some jagged lines here. And then when we put our color, we'll make the boat brown. And then we'll make this part really dark. And maybe that's another good spot to put some eyes in there as if something lives in there as well. Coming down from the masts, I'm just going to put some old kind of rotten sails. This is another really good detail to put on here. And then, just as kind of decoration, I'm going to put two sets of lines next to each other as kind of the railing of the ship. Ooh, this looks pretty cool. And I'll go back and erase that mast so it doesn't overlap there. So here's your shipwreck. Maybe you can have it sitting on like a rock or something. Wedged down in there. You can also put these little dots on the sand because the bottom's sandy. Now, I'm not going to put dots on every single part of the sand. But anywhere the sand kind of rises, you can put larger grains of sand at the top if you want. All right. One of my friends asked me to draw an octopus, so let's do an octopus. Octopus are easy. Starts getting a little bit squirrely when you start doing all the arms, but we're gonna do it. Oh yeah, someone asked to do a seahorse. We can do a seahorse too. I actually can do a pretty sweet looking seahorse. All right, so here we go. Octopus. All right, I'm gonna start off with my eyes, as always. And I have a feeling that maybe the shark over here is looking at the octopus to eat him. So we're gonna make him look really surprised and scared. Some people are like, yeah, I ran out of room. That's okay. Now, I'm gonna make the octopus kind of swimming away. And what we need to do is we need to make his head very round. So I'm gonna start kind of toward the bottom here and come up just like that. That's exactly what you want to see. I want you guys to focus very closely on how I do the legs, because I've practiced a lot with the legs to make them look good. We'll just put like a real small mouth, even though we know that octopus don't really have a small mouth like that, but he's freaking out. We're gonna add some spots on his head because that's gonna add some nice color. Make them different sizes. Now, for his arms, we know that he has eight. Now, we don't have to draw all eight because some of his legs are gonna be toward the back of him. So some of them can be hidden or some of them can be different sizes, but we have to sell it. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna make his legs look kind of like this. And I just kind of want to see how many I have to draw. So right now I have four. One, two, three, four. Here's five, six, seven, eight. Now, these legs we are seeing the tops of because they're the closest. But these arms in the back, we're actually seeing the bottom of them. So on the bottom of those, that's where we're going to put his suckers. This, we're basically seeing kind of the side of his leg. So I'm going to draw some suckers on the side. These are way behind him. And when we color this guy, that'll look really cool. I hope I'm not going too fast. I want you guys to make sure that you guys can keep up here. My friend Keith just signed on. I'm sure he'll want a woodpecker. It's kind of his constant request of whatever I do art-wise. He needs a woodpecker. Understandable. All right, let's do a seahorse. Let's do a seahorse. And then my girl Sid wants to do a puffer fish. That sounds fun. All right, so here is a seahorse. I got my eyes. And then for his mouth, you want to do something a little bit like that. And then we'll make his belly big. And they got like little flippers like that. Right, not my best seahorse, but I think you guys get the deal. I think he's pretty solid. All right. Someone asked to do a whale. I usually put my whales way in the background because they're so big. I don't like putting them way up front because the perspective is kind of messed up. But if you want to do a whale, nice big eyes. We're going to kind of do a similar thing as we did to the shark. I need to fix his back a little bit. And then for the whale, I like to do kind of make him look like a humpback whale. So he's got these big lines that come down like this. That's a pretty sweet whale. So he's coming in to just basically wreck shop to check the party out. He's coming out of nowhere. What's going on in here? All this fish action. All right, a lot of people are requesting a mermaid. So we'll do a mermaid. Now, obviously, the mermaid is going to look not as beautiful as everyone would want it to be. But I'm going to do my best. So when we're drawing girls, we always make them with big, pretty eyes, with a smaller nose. Maybe even put like a little shell in her hair or something like that or whatever. I'm trying to figure out how I want her hands. So maybe she's waving to us. Hello. We'll give her a seashell bikini. And then give her some scales on her legs. Mermaid. I like it. All right, someone asked me to do an eel. An eel is super easy, so I'm going to do an eel real quickly. And then I'll see if I can get to some of the other stuff that you guys asked. Eel is super easy. So here's my eyes. And once you can get to this spot, you're basically almost done. So here's the smile. And eels aren't really smiling creatures, but. And then we take it and we go back. And we make it smaller and smaller and smaller. And then we do the same thing inside. There's an eel. Right, wow, we've been drawing for 45 minutes, guys. Most people are still with me. I appreciate it. That's pretty neat. So there's your eel, there's your mermaid. Someone asked me to do a sea rabbit. Obviously, they're stayed up too late last night or something. I don't know what they're doing. All right, so a puffer fish. Puffer fish. Let's see here. All right, Sydney, here's your puffer fish. I'm gonna try. I've never drawn a puffer fish, so you guys are gonna have to just roll with it. Then we're gonna kind of draw like a big ball, and then we're gonna draw different size spikes kind of all over him. Trying for it not to look like a landmine or a mine underwater. But I think you guys get the idea. All right, Sid. There's your puffer fish. I'll have to work on him a little bit. Actually, I really like my puffer fish. All right, somebody asked to do a sea turtle. I think that's a great idea. And maybe we'll end today on on a sea turtle. I'm gonna put the sea turtle way up at the top. All right, so I'm gonna put my sea turtle right above the, what is that? Seahorse, right above my seahorse. All right, so here we go. Here's my eyes for my sea turtle. Okay. I'm going to take his shell. He's going off the paper a little bit, but that's okay. And for his shell, we're just going to put like little spots. Those little, I don't even know, I'm not sure what those markings are called, actually. I probably should know that, but I don't. And then I'm thinking of like a loggerhead turtle. So I'm thinking a loggerhead turtle would look something like this. And we'll even give him a couple air bubbles. All right, not exactly Crush from Finding Nemo, but I think he looks pretty good. All right, so let's look out and see what we did here. I'm actually running out of room. That's pretty solid, guys. That is pretty solid. If you want to keep going, you can over here, like by the pirate ship, you can pencil in like a treasure box or maybe some cannons. Maybe a sword sticking out of the sand. So much cool detail you guys can put on this. So we drew a little bit longer than I thought we would, and that's totally okay. I hope you guys like signing up for today. I will post on my website if we're going to do something tomorrow. Probably will. I don't know. If you guys like it and you guys want to keep joining me and you like my kind of silly little drawings, we can keep doing something. We can also do something that may be a little bit more difficult, but we'll cross that bridge when we get there. So thanks everybody for kind of signing on and drawing with me. If you guys would like, I can take a picture of this and I'll put it up on my website if you guys want to use my drawing and print it off and color it. That would be really cool. I'd love to see how you guys could color your own as well. So thank you guys very much for signing on and checking it out. I will hopefully see you guys tomorrow. Have a good day.